favor he has put in our
lives,
for the love he has shown us, the love of Jesus. We don't see it on money only, but the love of Jesus. To know that Jesus loves you, you see it on your life that you have. Many people have been buried this week. Many people are in hospitals
this week.
But you, what shows that God is with you? You're still alive and
you're
even though many people have been
sick,
but still the grace of God has been with you. And you've been
healed.
Doctors have been
here
and they have treated you. Those are the signs that show that God is with you and that God loves you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, you have us with.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord.
I thank God for the wonderful things he has done in this house.
Never Sakatono Rebido Jibiakosu Munyombe, no?
I thank God for the blessing he has given us. This year has been hard year to me. And was a hard year in this house. But because God loves us, he has shown signs and wonders that is going far with us. And many people are asking, show us your God. You people, you have God. People, they don't know that the church has God. People, they say that you people, you have God. But majority, they don't know that you have God. Praise be to God.
Amen.
But we thank God that slowly by slowly is revealing this community that we have God. That the God whom we worship, that is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
So by the end of this year, many people will be testifying on us that the God of JKMI is the God who is
alive
and is the only God that will need.
Many
people have been doing renovation and people have been calling
me.
But pastor, people thought that you were down. People thought that you were down. That you have no money. But the news is going around that the church is going to be renovated. That is our goal. These signs are not the end. These are just the signs. Just like the Bible says. But those who believe, the signs and wonders are for them. These signs are not the end. Our end is to see that we are
young.
And to see that we are
born.
That's what God showed us. In the name of Jesus. And if God refuses, and if the
world
is, even if it's 15 years, it comes
down.
When God told
you,
are you going to be the father of nations? 15 years gone, passed. And then he became the father of nations. There's something happened on
that.
When God speaks something in your life,
it doesn't matter.
How
long it will take?
As
long as you store it in your mind. And you store it in your heart. That God spoke this to me. It must pass. Whenever you keep on renewing it in your heart, time comes and it comes to pass. So now we are speaking about building here cathedrals. And some of you, I see your hearts are trying to pass or calculating how we will build the cathedral. We need to be possible. But you who were with me in the beginning, we know where we began. We were in the mud under the mango tree. Praise be the Lord.
Amen.
Right now we are just under cemented
base.
And this is not our destiny. This is just to show that the God born again is works. And shows that the God of born again quickly answers the prayers. We no longer need to be here for 10 years to build a cathedral. Our God works quicker than the God of religions. We no longer need to have a big glass to build a cathedral here. God in your worship is able to do both mega things. We no longer need to have a bigger class to build. But God in your worship will make it to build. I was telling Pastor Abdul recently, I feel we have sold. We have sold for next year. People are going to start building. And people are going to buy land. Next year, people in this church are going to start building. And
they
are going to buy land. Including me. Next year, I have to start building. Because we have sought, we have sought. Our God is merciful. We can't stop. We can't waste our time. And we be here coming concrete. And our God fails to answer our prayers. We can't start our small money. And we put it in the church. And we end up in the miserable life. It is impossible. You can't waste your time looking for the builders here. And God fails to answer your prayers. You have sold. You can't carry your money and you buy food for the church. And God fails to answer your prayers. Next year, people are going to testify here. Pastor have got land. Pastor have started building. Around people are going to testify. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our God is faithful. And I always tell you, it doesn't matter. Either you are 5, either you are 10. The many things to allow Jesus Christ to rule your life. When Jesus Christ rules your life, things will go ahead. It doesn't matter. Either you are struggling now, as long as Jesus Christ rules your life, things will change within a short time. That's the God whom we worship. That's the God whom we worship. And that's the God who goes with us.
Who
will always go with us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise
the Lord.
I want us to open a scripture. Luke chapter 19.
Verse 29.
n'atuma ku bayigirizwa be babiri ng'abagamba nti mugende mu mbuga eri mu maaso gammwe. Bwe munaayingira omwo munaalaba omwana gw'endogoyi nga gusibiddwa ogutebagalwangako muntu, mugusumulule muguleete. Era omuntu bw'ababuuza nti mugusumululira ki, mugambe bwe mutyo nti Mukama waffe yagwetaaga. N'abo abaatumibwa ne bagenda ne balaba nga bwe babagambye. Awo bwe baali nga basumulula omwana gw'endogoyi, bannanyinigo ne babagamba nti mugusumululira ki omwana gw'endogoyi ogwo?
Yes.
Ne bagamba nti Mukama waffe yagwetaaga. Ne bakuleeta eri Yesu, ne baalirira engoye zaabwe ku mwana gw'endogoyi ne beebagazaako Yesu. Awo yali ng'agenda ne baalirira engoye zaabwe mu luguudo 37. Awo yali ng'anaatera okutuuka ku kiiko ky'olusozi lwa Zeyituuni, ekibiina kyonna ekyabayigirizwa ne batanula okusanyuka n'okutendereza Katonda n'eddoboozi ddene olw'ebyamagero byonna bye baalaba. Nga bagamba nti aweereddwa omukisa Kabaka ajjira mu linnya lya Mukama, emirembe mu ggulu n'ekitiibwa mu waggulu ennyo.
Mukama yeebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
The cart was walking on those crosses.
Endogoyi yali etambulira ku
ngoye. It was the cart which was stepping on it.
Endogoyi yali erinnya ku ngoye eso.
Basebenyebanyebo.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ebiseera bingi Yesu ayagala okutukozesa.
Many times Jesus want to use us.
Yesu ayagala okutugambula mungu.
Jesus want to reign in our lives.
Yesu ayagala okubeera nga yafugambula mungu.
Jesus wants to reign in our lives.
Yesu ayagala okwebagala nga gwe mutwe gwa.
Jesus want to be our head.
Kubanga Yesu afugambula mungu.
Because when Jesus reigns in all your life.
Bible egamba nti Yesu ngafugambula mungu.
You will see that when Jesus reigns in your life.
Anyefulukeggulawo.
The way is open.
Ofuna chitima chota funanga ko.
To get the glory that you never got.
The Bible is saying. That the day the carrot accepted Jesus Christ to use it. The day the carrot was obedient to Jesus Christ. The day the carrot allowed Jesus Christ to move his life. That whenever you are going. When we are sweeping the ways, when we are laying down the crosses, and the carrot must be enjoying, when Jesus Christ moves over your life, expect the doors to open for you. The carrot accepted Jesus Christ to move over its life. The Bible is saying that when we are sweeping the ways for it, because it was going with the King of Kings, it was carrying Jesus Christ in his side. You cannot carry Jesus Christ in your life. And since he means the same, the day you allow Jesus Christ to rule your life, the day you allow Jesus Christ to go with you, the day you allow Jesus Christ to intervene in your business, the day you allow Jesus Christ to rule over your life, everything will change. The Bible is saying that the life of the
carnal,
it changed. It changed because it had Jesus Christ in his life. We need to allow Jesus Christ in our lives. When Jesus Christ is over your life, every door you wish will open. Because the day Jesus Christ started ruling over the life of carrot. When Jesus Christ started ruling over the carrot, the Bible is saying that the life of the carrot changed. It was no longer untied. It was no longer in prison. It was no longer in captivity. devil. It was no longer in struggling. It was enjoying with Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ moves your life, when Jesus Christ enters your life, when Jesus Christ enters your business, every customer comes to you. When Jesus Christ is in your business, when you surrender your business to Jesus Christ, customers will flow into your business because you are in the current surrender to serve Jesus Christ. The Bible says that we are laying glasses and we are sweeping for me. And the carrot was enjoying those beautiful ways, those sweet ways, and they were worshipping Jesus Christ. And the more they were worshipping Jesus Christ, even the carrot was enjoying. When Jesus Christ is in your life, people, they start seeing Christ in you. When you allow Jesus Christ to be over you, when you allow Jesus Christ to be above you, people will start seeing you. People will start seeing the form of Jesus Christ. They will start seeing the image of Jesus Christ as part of you. Praise be the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus Christ can't come with you.
Yes, that's so well.
And things do not change in your life. That is impossible. The day I separated Jesus Christ through my life, the day things started changing my life. It doesn't matter, it's above mountains. But when Jesus Christ is ruling my life, I have hope that will be sweeping from the way, and people will be testifying that woman has life, that woman has Jesus Christ, that man has God, that man has money, that man has money. Because the Jesus you have is a powerful God, is a powerful Lord. You cannot shame these people. The carrot before the seat of Jesus Christ, it was in prison. It was on the law. It was struggling. It was not enjoying. It was living a miserable life. When Jesus Christ entered his life, his name started working on the closet because it was carrying a mighty cross. Jesus Christ is standing in your life. That is when you see people worshiping your God. And when you are worshiping your God, you are enjoying the privileges. When you are enjoying the privileges, the doors will be opening. You will be sweeping for the ways. You will sweep the ways of the God. That is the power of Jesus Christ. When he is in your life, when he is in your life, when he is your home, when he's in your children, when he's in your business, things start working smoothly. You start enjoying it. Because people will be seeing Jesus Christ in yourself. They will not be seeing Ivan in your business, but they will be seeing the image of Jesus Christ. Because God created you in his image, Christ will sit in your place and will come in your business. Let us go to other business. Let us go to other business. Because Jesus Christ in your life, you don't need to go into the shrine. You need just to allow Jesus Christ to open your life. When you open your life and you start driving you, and you start writing you, and you start directing you, things are going to change. When you took the life of the carrot, when you start ruling the life of the carrot, it's the beginning of the change of the life of the carrot. The Bible says that when we are walking the way, the people came on the road. they started worshiping. They started praising. And they were praising. The Pilot was enjoying. The Pilot was walking on the process. On the ways which they had swept. When Jesus comes over your life, your ways are going to be swept. Your ways are going to be swept. The ways of receiving money are going to be clean. The ways of capital are going to be clean. That is Jesus Christ when he's doing your life. When Jesus Christ takes over your life, you no longer need to struggle to drive. You no longer need to struggle to grow. Because Jesus Christ is heavenly slave. The pilot was in prison. He was tied struggling with problems. He was tied struggling with burdens. The ropes were on his leg. But when Jesus Christ intervened in, and the pilot surrendered, Jesus Christ used my life. Take that where you want. It was the beginning of the dressing of the pilot. From today onwards, let Jesus Christ rule your life. When he rules your life, you are going to rejoice and you are going to enjoy. Because Jesus Christ is everything. When they are saying to a Yaguamu,
when they are saying that
one
is down, when you have Jesus, it's just the beginning. Because Jesus is the beginning and the end. Some people think that you end
it.
But Jesus, when
he's
in your life, it's just the beginning. When people say that it is the end for you, and when they have started to pity you, and they have started to say, oh, sorry, that woman.
Yes,
which you have, Jesus is just the beginning. Many people pity me. Many people say that they pity that man. He has a degree in tourism, but he's not working in tourism. But they have forgotten that I have Jesus. And for some people who speak, the things they have done, they cannot wish on what Jesus, when he's in your life, when you move a journey, when you are sure, everything that you lay your hand on, many people come. Because the people said that the people came in large numbers to see the cult. Because it had Jesus. They came along the ways. And they started to worship. And they started to worship. Giving glory. Because it was carrying Jesus. I've told you that people have been calling you.
See
the Jew man, you still have money.
They see I had money, but me I see I've never had money.
It is just the beginning for me.
Yes.
And even with Jesus,
we
are just the beginning. They
said
that that man still
has
money. They are innovating. They
said
that man still has money. They are innovating the church.
We are just the beginning.
They will come along the ways to worship. That the
body
dance from JKMI are coming. When Jesus is with us leading. That is Jesus. They will come. And they will say, when did this one begin to build? How did the she purchase the land from that business?
Yes.
Jesus
can
do great and mighty things. things for you.
When
he was in the life of the
town,
people came along the way to wash. And they said, look at the cult. But they came to wash because the cult had Jesus.
So yes,
now when Jesus reigns your life, they will come along the way to watch.
Now
look at Ashadan. He has bought a car even if for 4 millions. God do wonders.
Yes,
Jesus.
When we allow him to rule our lives and become our heads, things are going to change. When we speak about mega things here, we speak about mega things because we are confident, we have confidence in Jesus Christ who does mega things.
If it is driving, we are
going to
drive because we are tired of walking. In 2 years, we
shall
be parking cars in the name of Jesus. It will be yours or it will be mine. In the next years, let everybody drive. Now some people are saying that, is that possible?
It is very possible with Jesus Christ. Very possible.
Look and see. If next year you not testify, that you started
including me, who is pastoring you, in the name of Jesus Christ, our God, whom we worship, when we give him time, to rule over your life, you no longer need to be blind in the church for 10 years. Zenariachi, yes, Sungavantu and again, Mukanisa Mono.
When you are complaining that people found you in the church, now they are breaking through.
The God of born again is a miracle worker.
Katonda wa falokole, katonda wa akola ya makero.
And he's a quicker God.
Ena, katonda wa abangu.
He does things which you could look for 20 years within 5 years.
Akole vintu mu miaka etambe wandikole te miaka abiri.
Osasura omuntu.
You put some people.
Naba unaba nanyoma omulokole.
When they are undermining the
born
again, they don't know the mystery in the born
again.
The mystery in the born again is to overcome. If all the born
again
who are here, you change your mind and you say that let Jesus reign in
your
mind, that let me send my life to Jesus.
Yes.
And you know that you were born again to be well in Jesus Christ. You will be well when you see that flesh. The problem we born again get. Some born again believe Jesus to kuna again. And the reason why they believe Jesus, they said that it was different.
But God, Jesus Christ had a bigger purpose for us. Not only just surviving hell. He wants to live our life and recreate relationship with him and changes our lives.
Ayagala
Nayo osanga omuntu nga ali confident yewaayo nyafiire mu bwavu.
Bwakuba
nyawo nageye neyamala okukkiriza Yesu.
N'atandika
n'okugamba nti anti obwakabaka obw'eggulu bwaffe abaavu.
The kingdom of God is for the poor.
Jesus Christ has never been poor.
Yesu Kristo tabanga ko mwavu.
Jesus Christ has never been poor.
Yesu tabanga ko mwavu.
If we receive him, we must be rich.
Fetubanga tumulinda tulina kubera bagaka.
When you read about Jesus Christ, you come to know why people are struggling to divide this closet. He was putting on the most expensive clothes, that's why everyone struggled to take the
piece. Yes, so much of the man to let us stay here and we share it.
He was putting on very expensive.
Yeah, Yamba don't pay.
He's the King of Kings. His father was very rich. An architect.
Tata wa yale mukaka.
You always read about Joseph.
Kutu soma for yourself.
He was an architect in the cities.
Yale
Jerusalem. They were rich. So when we allow Jesus Christ to rule our lives,
even
us we shall be rich. We shall survive him and we shall be rich. So throw one and you wanna come when you pay.
Don't strive just to get ready to be saved from ahead.
Katumkam Yesu na atumula na gamba katumuga igabu nobu nabu nabuachi.
Now when Jesus said that, what's the
use of this?
The owner doesn't want them.
Because you are afraid to establish a proper relationship with him.
You
are afraid to surrender totally him through your life. But the day you do it like the carrot, things will change. The doors are going to open. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I dedicate these people to your presence. These are your sons. These are your children. You have been a co-worker. And you say that signs and wonders will follow your believers. Let good signs and wonders follow these people. Let your favor follow these people. In the name of Jesus Christ. As you went with the carrot, Lord, I dedicate these people to go with them. Go with them everywhere. Go with them to their works. Go with them in their business. Go with them in their families and their children. Go with them in towns and everywhere. Let the ways get opened. Let the ways be clear. As that we are clear for the tarot. The ways of money. Let them be clear. So that they receive money. And your name be glorified. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, bless these people. Let them see the blessing of our grants. The blessing of our fathers. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let them, Father, rejoice in your presence. Let them see peace in your presence. Let them develop in your presence. Let their life change in your presence. Let their homes develop in your presence. your presence. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I dedicate those private upon these people. Prosperity upon these people. I declare prosperity in their lives. I declare prosperity in their lives. Because you are God of prosperity. I declare a positive change in their lives. Because you are God of change. I declare a victory in your life. Because you are God of victory. I declare a longer life in their lives. Because you are God of life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let these people live for years and years as they enjoying the prosperity you gave them. Let them live years and years. They see their children enjoying on the fruit you have given them. Let them live years and years. And see their grandchildren enjoying the seeds, the fruits you have given them. In the name of Jesus Christ, once we shall stand and glorify your name. We shall always glorify your name. We shall always exalt it up. We shall always testify about it. And the God of JKMI Church, the God of our fathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is the one who has uplifted us. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we commit ourselves to keep on testifying your name. Father, we commit ourselves that we shall always testify your name, that everything we have, it came from you. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Father, for loving us. Thank you, Lord, for taking care of us, loving our families, our parents, our children, our grandchildren, in the name of Jesus Christ. May your name always be glorified. We give you honor and glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. The blessing of our grands, the blessing of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, go with you this week and the rest of the days in the name of Jesus Christ. Once he was musalaba,
wali wa amani. Ako ega tuonya, niwa deso
kumuyo ngamba wansiwo musa igwei.
Waliwo amani, ako ega tuonya, niwa deso
kumuyo.
Praying God Jesus.